let's take a look at the rhomboid muscles on the right side of the body. We have a lateral to medial view and posterior to anterior. So we're looking at the posterior surface of the person's back. So when the trapezius is in place, we can see that it covers most of the rhomboids. We can see a little bit of the rhomboid musculature peeking out here. Context here, this is the inferior angle of the scapula. There is the medial border. This is the spine of the scapula. This is the root of the spine of the scapula at the medial border. And the superior angle of the scapula would be up about here. The spine, spinous processes of the spine, are running midline over here. We have cut the trapezius, and we can reflect the trapezius back. And now we have a nice view of the rhomboids. The rhomboids attach medially onto the spinous processes of C7 through T5, and from there they run inferiorly and laterally to attach onto the medial border of the scapula, from the root of the spine of the scapula down to the inferior angle. It is usually said that there is a rhomboid minor and a rhomboid major, that the rhomboid minor attaches to the spinous processes of C7 and T1 and then attaches onto the root of the spine of the scapula, the medial border right here. And the rhomboid major attaches from the spinous processes of T2 through T5 and attaches along the medial border of the scapula just below the root of the spine down to the inferior angle. Now, we can see here that there is no very, very clear discernment of where it's rhomboid minor to major. It's probably right about in here. In some cadavers, it's more obvious. There's more of a fascial separation. In this one, there really is not much of one. Now, because the rhomboids attach onto the scapula, they can move the scapula at the scapulocostal or scapulothoracic joint. And certainly, they would move the scapula toward the midline and up. I'd like to make a point about this particular rhomboid musculature here. Rhomboid means diamond shape, and that means that the attachments on one side, the lateral border attachments, the medial border attachments, should be parallel, and they're approximately parallel here. The superior border and inferior border should be parallel. But if we look at this superior border here, and we look at it here, and we place our probe at the inferior angle and say this is parallel, we can see that this rhomboid major spreads out. And in fact, if we were to count spinous processes, it's going below the typical T5. So there are very often anomalies in the human body, and this cadaver demonstrates an anomaly of the rhomboid musculature. For a little bit of context, we've already seen that it's deep to trapezius, where they overlap each other. Here is the infraspinatus, here is the supraspinatus, levator scapulae is here, there's a little triangle between rhomboids and levator scapulae here. Down here, we can see the paraspinal erector spinae musculature running vertically. So we have just looked at the rhomboid musculature on the right side of the body, again from spinous processes of C7, T1, usually to T5, going over to attach onto the medial border of the scapula from the root of the spine of the scapula down to the inferior angle.